I wanted to do a grass flipping video, and there's really not a whole lot of places to flip grass in Oklahoma, except for this place, which has got tons and tons of milfoil, a little bit of hydrilla, it's clear water. It's a little bit deeper lake. It's a small lake, but I was here in the spring this year and seeing what lives here, and there are some pretty big ones down here. And so we're gonna flip grass, we're gonna punch it, throw frog, and see if we can catch a big old bag. All right, so a lot of people say whenever you're flipping, you need to flip with your opposite hand that you reel with. This, I mean, it's true, but to a certain extent. So when you're flipping miles and miles of grass, like you can see this big mat up here, that's the case. But when you're flipping isolated targets and you need to be accurate, flip with what you're accurate with. But as far as grass, left hand is the way to go. Pick the tallest pine, dig it real deep where the roof stood mine, cross the Red River, well, it opens wide, the hair one sails to the Choctaw side, follow my trail to a silver stone, and get the man. Is what lives in the hydrilla. That's not really hydrilla, that's milfoil. That's a 5. Put them on the outside of the mouth. I don't know what the deal is with that, but that's a big one. That's what's not supposed to be there. On chatterbait. Oh, he come off. There's a whole school of them there.
dance. Promise me a place from here much better. There's aftermath and ties and tracks, your rib dog. Give it all up for me. Said you save a dime.
Okay, so whenever you're flipping matted hydrilla or miffle, whatever it is, this is not what you want to see. It's like, it kind of looks like gummy, and it's floated to the top like you want it, but it's like, it's dead. And I can't get bit in this stuff, but say this was the good milfoil, which I'll show y'all in a little bit. So you've got basically all this scattered stuff out here and where the big mat is. So it'll kind of make like a, see that, that's a little point right there. So that point, and that point, and then there's like the meat of it. So depending on where you're at, if you're getting bit on the points, like here and here, and like that point over here, then they're on the points. But a lot of times they'll get like in this little ice that I do, they'll be right smack dab in the middle of it. And I'm using a 1.25 ounce to get through this. I'd like to get away with an ounce, but this stuff is just a little bit too thick. But yeah, so all this scattered stuff out here, it's not any good. You want that mat right here to where the thickest part right there, that's where they'll be. And when we're working that chatterbait, you can see that here's the thick part of the grass, and then there's just a bare spot right here. So I get on that live scope and I can see the edge right there, and I just throw that chatterbait right down the edge. That's how I caught every one of them on that chatterbait.
So when you're flipping grass, a lot of times the fish will tell you what they want. So if they bite it as soon as it goes in there, you could probably catch them on a frog. But this day at this specific lake, I was having to leave it in there for 5-10 seconds before they even bite it. And that's just how it is sometimes, and they pretty much tell you what they want.
This is the good stuff. Nice and green. See, it's matted over there. So that matted area right there is where they'll be. This right here, they'll get in it, but they scatter out pretty good and you can't really pinpoint it. But you can see how there's like a point right here, a point right here, and then like right smack dab in the middle. I mean, that's the three spots they're gonna be. All right, so basically what I was using was on the punch rig was a 7.6 medium heavy flipping stick. And I don't like a super long rod when I'm flipping, when I'm punching. I use the 7.6 medium heavy whenever I'm using 1.25 ounce to a 3/4 ounce tungsten weight. 65 pound braid, high speed reel. I don't like 8s, I like 7s. 8s, you kind of get bogged down. 7s, it's about right. I'm using a legendary tungsten 1.25 ounce flipping weight. These tungsten weights right here, they're cheap. They're not like cheap as in quality, but it's the best deal you're gonna find, that's why I get them. And this is a legendary nunchuck. And I've caught 80% of my fish on this year. It's got the same profile as a Strike King Menace, but it's not. This is actually thicker plastic, so you can get more fish out of one bait. So I usually get 2 to 3 fish on this bait. Every other bait with that soft plastic, you get one fish and it's done.
And it doesn't have the flutter. I mean, they're split, but it's got more of a glide. And it comes down, and they bite it everywhere I go, north, south, whatever. I snail the knot. See the weight comes down. And as soon as it sticks out the hook, and it goes right into the roof of the mouth. So that's the flipping setup. And then I was just throwing a half ounce jackhammer chatterbait with a Gary Yamamoto Zaku, I think that's what it's called. 20 pound fluorocarbon, 7.3:1 gear ratio, anything in a 7. And that was pretty much it. It got pretty tough on us as the sun got up, which with grass, usually that's what you want, but the grass down there wasn't really that deep. So the fish that I did catch in that grass, they were underneath the mat about 4 foot. Really, whenever you're flipping grass, you need that 5 to 10 to really get a true giant. I think that those fish out there were out there a little bit deeper off them points, off them drops, and them brush piles. But I wanted to do a grass flipping video. So, caught some fish, had about 15 pounds on our best 5, which is pretty good for August in Oklahoma. That's a great lake down there. I've only been there a few times, but it's a great lake. I'm going to be doing some more of these technique-specific videos, maybe one, maybe two more before I go back up north. So thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time.